Hi, it's Anthony here for Semi-Informatic, and welcome back to Basic Training. This is episode 4 in our series of 7 Days to Die, and in today's episode we're going to be teaching you how to reinforce your base for the Day 7 Horde. So let's get right into it. Okay, so here we are just before dawn. During the night I moved a bunch of my stuff out of this chest, so there's no food and medical supplies in here anymore. They're all in this chest, just to keep things a little bit separate and easy to find. I also melted down some iron things and some brass things and some glass things. Just items that you pick up that don't have any use, like the piercings or the candlesticks, things like that. So today we're going to be looking for wood and we're going to be looking for iron. We're probably going to need around 500 iron and as much wood as you can get your hands on. So get ready for a lot of resource gathering today. Also, it's a good opportunity to pick up feathers and make sure that you can make around about 250 arrows. So let's get ready to go. Actually, what I am going to do is take my frames out. Let's just have a quick look, because I did see a zombie, or hear a zombie, or heard something earlier. All looks good. Well, at least for the time being. So the first thing I want to do is finalize this structure here. And what I really want is I want a gap of 2 between my front door and everything else. Just so that if any zombies walk up there, they just fall straight back down. Alright, well that looks pretty good, so let's finalize that. This doesn't need to be reinforced, you can rebuild this if it gets damaged. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to gather some iron and we're going to upgrade these poles into metal reinforced poles. So what you're going to be looking for is these boulders here. Now you can get iron by mining it out of the ground if you find an iron deposit, but it's not really likely that we'll find one above ground. These boulders are going to be our best source of iron, so you'll probably need to mine let's say 500, depending on how much you've already got. You're going to go through axes today, I think. It won't hurt to have some stones available. Whoop, jeez. It won't hurt to have some stones available, but if you're mining these boulders, you're going to get stones whether you like it or not. Alright, so let's head back. And let's just pop the iron that we smelt in the forge. And let's make some iron at the same time. Alright, so what will happen is that the iron will be created, and because the forge is running, whatever's in here will be smelted as well. In fact, we can even pop this lead in there. Now that should go pretty quick. Let's get us some wood. Now, if you haven't got enough food for today, make sure you take care of that too. So the wood we're going to use to make into log spikes. Now you can make wooden spikes, but it takes 100 wood per set of wooden spikes. So at this skill level, it would take you a little while to gather all the wood that you needed. And this will get us past day 7 just fine. Now when we pick up seeds, of course, we plant them. Generally a little bit away from your base, but not too far. You want some good sight lines for when you have to shoot at zombies. Alright, let's see how that iron's going. That's probably finished. Actually, let's start making some spikes while we're doing all this. Wood log spikes. 20 each as opposed to 100. And let's just start off by making 20. We're probably going to need more than that, but there's no sense in just using all of our wood at once. We might have a need of it at some later stage today. Say making arrows. Have a look around every now and then, make sure there's no zombies sneaking up on you too. Yeah, you're gonna go through the axes today as well. Oh, now we've hit an issue. I probably shouldn't have queued up all of those wood log spikes, because now we have to wait for those to finish before we can remake our axe. So now's a good time to check on our iron, which is finished. Oh no, not quite, almost. Gee, we timed that well. Let's pop the rest of our iron in here. Let's keep the crafting going. Now we've got some iron left over in this chest from just scavenging. Let's pick that up as well. Alright, let's have a look at our axe. Whoop. Help if I could type. So with the axe, if we just right click on these pillars, they'll be upgraded. Now be careful to stop when you get to the first level of upgrading, because there is a second level and you'll go through your iron really quickly if you go to that second level. If you have enough iron, by all means, knock yourself out. Okay, 10 left, which isn't quite enough for us to keep going. And let's make it a bit easy to get into our base as well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, well, let's say 6. We just want to make 6 wooden stairs. Let's just go up and collect some more iron. Nice round number. Yep, now we're at. Alright, let's have a look at those stairs. You can rotate these when you place them if you haven't got the orientation right, but it's best just to sit directly in front of the thing that you're looking to place them on. Alright, and that'll make it a little bit easier for us to get up rather than having to jump all the time. Alright, so let's continue on collecting some iron. Now the reason we're doing all of the iron first before the spikes is that once we place the spikes, it will make it difficult for us to get under our base and do things like make repairs and things like that. So we're getting this out of the way first. If you do need to get under your base to make repairs, you can always place some wooden frames on top of the spikes and walk over them that way. Alright, we have to be careful how much we craft here, because we don't want to use iron that we're going to need for other things. Just go with this for now. Let's have a look and try and figure out how many more we've got to do. So let's say that's fully upgraded. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so 140 iron. We've got 5, so let's say 135. Whoop. Craft that. 1 minute 52, 1 minute 40. So I'm going to make that without popping a little bit more wood in. Of which, let's go and get some wood. There's a tree stump here. I wonder if it's searchable. Yep. What do we got? Oh, vitamins. Not really sure what they're for, actually. Maybe a food substitute or something like that. I've never used them, so they can't be that important. Or maybe they are. Maybe I'm playing the game wrong. Sometimes it can be good just to circle strafe a tree when you're working it, just to see whether anything's sneaking up behind you. So let's finish some of these off. Oh, that one wasn't even upgraded with wood. Neither was that one. Oh, we have a supply drop. Now, you'll notice that the supply drops in my game are marked on my map, or at least on my compass. This is an option that you can turn on. The default is that they're not marked. So don't be surprised if you don't see them. You can see the thing falling. Now, whether or not you can take the time to go and pick it up, that's a judgment you have to make based on how ready you think you are for day 7. We're doing fairly well, so I'm going to go and pick it up, or at least try. The only problem is I don't like the, like, if that area over there, it doesn't look that bad. There's an area that on your map that appears red, that's kind of like a wasteland or a badlands or something like that. And, ooh, bird's nest. And it has zombie dogs in it, and zombie dogs in this game are terrifying, and they do a lot of damage, and they can cause you to bleed out real quick. So I try to avoid them until I have a good supply of antibiotics and bandages and things like that. Now we've entered an area we haven't visited before, so zombies are spawning all over the place. I have seen supply crates land up trees. If that happens, try to build a box tower to get to it. Don't cut the tree down because the crate will be destroyed when the tree falls over. A rabbit freaking out in the ground there. We're exhausting ourselves stamina-wise here. There's our crate up there. Now we use it. And we loot quickly. We got some schematics. Well, just some schematics. The crate then destroys itself, and then we are faced with the run back. Hopefully we can get through these before... Yep. Like I said, for day 7, 200 to 250 arrows, depending on how generous the spawner is to you. It's always good to have more arrows than less. Now, because we took this chance to go after the supply drop, we might not get enough time to go hunting today. Just make sure you've got a little bit of extra food left over, whether it's canned food, like an emergency food supply. You can make things that will improve your stamina regeneration and stop it from going down quite so fast. Coffee is one of them, I believe. Although I just haven't had a chance to make that sort of stuff. It all depends on how important time is for you. And at the moment, we're not doing too badly. We'll be ready for day 7, barring any unforeseen accidents. At least it's giving us a good chance to collect some feathers. Just giving these houses a bit of a wide berth. Just stopping occasionally to loot the birds' nests as well gives us a chance to get a little bit of stamina back. Looks like he might get away. Now, I know I said I've got a lot of food, but when you run right across a pig like that, It's very difficult to resist the temptation of just getting that little bit extra food that might be the difference between going hungry one night and having something to eat. There's the other pig off to the left taunting me, too. But we do seem to have run close to that farm that we saw earlier. I have seen dogs spawn at farms before, so, you know, blindly chasing a pig into an area that you're not familiar with might not be the best idea, but it worked out well in this case. A nice little boost to our athletics, too. All right, almost home. You'll start to find that the birds' nests closer to your base have been well pillaged at this point. So do we lose that zombie off to the left that we saw? Well, he sensed us, but... So let's grab our stuff, and if he comes too close, we'll come out and deal with him. Maybe we'll just deal with him now. Sort of mindful of that other one in the distance as well. They're probably chasing me because I'm holding meat. Probably, by the looks of things. Hope we get this done in time. Can shoot a pig while running down the road, but... sometimes miss point-blank shots. Oh, honey. Now, honey is useful because it can act as an antibiotic in the early stages of infection. Alright, let's get rid of some of this stuff we picked up. So meat and honey and food and medical stuff in the top chest. Second chest is just kind of everything else. I'm going to keep the pine cones because I'll end up planting them before the day's out. Forgot the eggs. All right, let's finish up here. So you're done, you're done, you're done. You're done. Alright, so we have our main pillars are now upgraded. Let's have a look at these woodlog spikes. You want them on the ground? Just start from the middle, work your way out. Now after you finish a set, upgrade them. Be careful upgrading them with iron in your inventory, because you can upgrade them to metal spikes accidentally. And, you know, metal spikes, there's value in that. But in this case, we really don't need it for day 7. And then just start filling in the gaps. Now these will hurt you too, so you need to start being careful around your base at this point. the plan is the zombies will walk around underneath these, or on top of these, sorry, and do damage to themselves while they're attacking your pillars, which will be reinforced so they won't be able to get through them. Alright, where are we at? Let's get ourselves some more wood. We really want another line of pillars, of spikes, before we turn in. Oh, that bear is back. Let's start making a... Maybe the spikes will serve as a deterrent for the bear. Let's make another 20 to start off with. Oh, I've done it again. My stone axe is almost done, and I'm off making spikes. You can cancel them. I'm sure you can find other things to do while the spikes complete. At some stage, before maybe even after day 7, we're probably going to have an issue with that bear, I would say. Alright, so let's take the spikes we've got. Make him real sure he's not going to come across the river. 20 might not be enough. Let's scrap that. Let's queue up a new one for when the spikes finish. Alright, nothing else to melt. What I might do is start some food for when we come back in. Let's get some bacon and eggs and some grilled meat. Let's pop our egg back. Definitely not going to be enough spikes, but we'll get there. Actually, I can tell we're going to need 4 more. Let's just leave them there for the time being. So now you can see we're starting to put things... And the 4 obviously just go in the corners. We're starting to put things underneath your staircase, in the hole where you climb over to get to your shelter. Now, just be careful you don't fall on them. Having said that, you're going to fall on them. I played this game both solo and with friends, and the amount of times that we've fallen on our own traps, it doesn't really bear thinking about. Just make sure that you've got a bandage on you if you need one in case you start bleeding. And get back inside and get yourself some food. Alright, what have we got? 369 wood. Let's just get a little bit more wood. the plan is going to be to grab this plant, whatever seeds we've got, head back up into our base and start to prepare for the night. Now, with the amount you've used your forge, you may get some zombie activity. If you stay crouched and you're not holding food that attracts them, they probably won't see you or hear you. If you do go from sensed to hunted, you can climb out onto your balconies and try and take them out if you want. Just don't fall off, obviously. Alright, let's get up there. There's no sign of that bear. Alright, so let's get ourselves some food. And some water. You can see as our wellness goes up, we slowly get bonus to health, bonus to stamina. So while we're doing all of this, let's cook that murky water up into bottled water. 2 minutes. Now, really nothing we can do with the forge at this point. We don't have anything else we can melt. So what did we get today? We got the coal, which is another type of fuel you can use. We're not really interested in it. Let's read all these schematics. This will give you a little bit of a skill up as well as teaching you the recipe. And we've put these jars in the wrong chest. They go in the food chest. A little bit of OCD. Right, so last of all, let's make some arrows. I'm getting at least close to our day 7 target of 200-ish arrows. Now you find that after you make these, your weaponsmithing skill is going to be have gone up quite a bit. So even if you look at this, whenever we make an arrow, up it goes. So make sure you remake your bow and your club. And even if you want, you can remake your shiv, although I don't tend to use a shiv for combat, and I just tend to use them until they break. Okay. Now, I had another idea. We just have to wait for the 40 seconds for the water to finish. So if you've got animal fat, you may have also picked up some cloth, or you may not have. If you don't have cloth, that's fine. Grab some of these clothes that you've been looting and scrap them. Is that an odd thought? Did I remember to remove the frames? Yeah, I did. Good. Almost there. The arrows, we are at... still 40 to go. Alright, last one. Alright, so now turn your animal fat into tallow. We'll pop the water back in the storage chest. How are we going here? Still a little while to go yet. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a torch. And see that we need tallow, a cloth fragment, and a piece of wood. Getting our cloth fragments from the clothes. If you've picked cotton, which is that stuff out there with the white tips, you can also turn that into cloth. So what I'll be looking to do is put a couple of torches around the outside of the house so when day 7 arrives I can see what's going on. Because it does get quite dark at night. Alright, yep, good. Now we're getting our cloth. So 4 tallow, And what I might do just before I do that, so we'll scrap our bow, which was 81, and we'll scrap our club, which was 80. If you remake your bow now. Yeah, 112, so it's always a good exercise to scrap your club and your bow after creating a whole bunch of arrows. Oh, and always remember to reload your bow too. Also, 200 arrows, bang on, but we'll make more if we can. So we've got 4 tallow, 7 cloth fragments. Let's just split the difference and do 7 arrows. Oh, sorry, 7 torches. We'll place them tomorrow morning. Minute 33. Okay, so yeah, that's day 4. We're pretty much ready for day 7 at this point. So the rest of the days are going to be gathering food and making further defenses that we think might help. One important point I should mention is do not dig a pit around your house and fill it with spikes. Zombies, when they attack, they can attack the ground if they think the ground is between you and them. And while we have some nice strong reinforced iron wood, the ground is much softer and the zombies will tunnel under your base and undermine your nice strong wooden iron pillars from underneath. So don't dig a pit and fill it with spikes. Just put spikes around your base. Okay, well, that's it from me. I hope you enjoyed this. I'll see you for day 5 tomorrow.